Hi. How y'all doing? It is power recap time. It's me, Mama Wawa, Wanda Wisdom channel here. Welcome. Okay, last night I watched Power, and then I watched it again. I watched it again in the same night. I usually don't, if I watch it again at all, it wouldn't usually be in the same sitting like that. But I said, you know what? I was taking notes. First time I watched it, I took notes, like I usually take notes when I watch it, since I started this little video feedback thingy here on this channel for Power. Yeah. So something said, you know what? Taking notes can be a little distracting. And I was getting up and getting snacks, and I was looking at something else. And I said, you know what? Let me just watch it again. So I watched it twice last night. Season 4, episode 4. They were calling it 404. And the second go around, pardon me, I'm drinking water. I should put a little essential oil in the water. I should put some lime, have some lime and essential oil. Anyway, never mind. Yeah, I would, And watching it the second time, I listened to Courtney Kemp's, her review. I think it's smart. I think it's cool that she does that because she imports her review before we YouTubers issue ours. Smart. It's cool. Yeah. I would if I was executive producer. I surely would. And, when I listened to a take, I was like, okay. And I also saw the, previews for the next episode. The next episode next week. It looks like it's really, really cooking up. Yeah. So let's get on to the review of this one. I get sidetracked. I've been made waste 20 minutes talking about Courtney's review, which make no sense. Let me give you mine. Okay, it opens up with Ghost working out in the weight room. And Charlie's Murphy's character, the late great Charlie Murphy. Ladies, he was fine. If you're young and you didn't see him from back in the days, I reckon you go on and look him up. Young ladies, look him up. He was gorgeous. And he had more weight on him, clearly, back then. Just to me, he was cuter than Eddie back then. Just cutie. The Dave Chappelle days and just a cutie. But I just... this role is making... I wonder if it's... Because they got melanated actors going at Ghost, like they, it's like they, never mind if you have to call this conspiracy theory, you can call it whatever we want to call it. That's this one CT. I have another CT in mind, which is critical thinking. I'm like, why they couldn't get a Caucasoid CO in the whole daggone thing to come at Ghost like this? Why they having just the melanated one, you know, break his balls like this? What kind of psychological message are they really trying to hope to? Not you, Courtney Kemp. I know you have your hidden bosses. Not even 50. It just, let me not get, but anyway, but this is really not making me not like Charlie. I'm like, is that the idea? Is it something to do with his zodiac sign, the sign he had when he was here in his last incarnation? I don't know, but, well, he sneaks into the weight room, needless to say, and does the thing with the barbells, and, you know, it's a scary scene. I mean, we're like, oh, okay, is there cameras in it? Or they cut the cameras off? Is he doing this on camera? You know, why? It's just relentless. It was just, and although outside of movie scripts and TV scripts, we do know that there are melanated law enforcement ones who really, really act like that, work real hard to defend the pale hidden powers that be. I don't know if it's for the sake of a paycheck or they just get to be a bully and get paid for it. Or I don't know. So It was just too much to look at. I had to walk away from certain scenes with Charlie and Ghost as usual. But this is not Charlie. I don't know his. I don't even know his name in this role. But you know that was his real given name. Blessings be upon your spirit, Charlie Murphy. But I had to walk away from them scenes. It's got to be the last way we remember him. Oh God. Okay, back to the script of Power. Ugh. All right, the next scene you have Angela and took notes. Now hold on now. Be patient or click off the video. Okay. Next scene is Angela and the other stiff suits with the smooth top table. They're talking about some shit. I don't know. Irritation. Okay. The next scene. Look. Yes, I saw it twice. I'm like talking about the asses right now. I'll get back to him in a minute. Okay, the next scene is Ghost with Ebony and Ivory in the room with the smooth top table. They're talking and whatnot about the case as usual, how shit is going to progress. Okay, the next scene, Angela trying to gas. Yeah, she's trying to run game and gas Tasha outside the coffee house. You know what, Tasha? I'm so glad you didn't go in the coffee house to sit down and have tea with that bitch. Bitch, I don't want to break bread with you or sip tea with the pinkies up to the damn ceiling. No, bitch, no, we don't break bread. We don't do that. Not you and I. So she tapped the window for the bitch to come outside. I look, whichever writer wrote that shit, kudos. Okay, from one writer to another, coop the fuck does. No. Tasha Hood. Where Angela from? Is she from Bayside? Are they from Queens somewhere? Is she from Queens? I don't know. Well, Bayside wasn't the hood when the hell I was in Queens. I don't know. I don't think, is Angie from the hood? But if she went to high school with Ghost and them, but they were from Queens. Was Ghost, how does Ghost know Slim? Is Ghost from the hood, Queens, and Bayside, Queens? And how did the shit merge and blend? What part of Queens is that? What the fuck? How does Ghost know Angie if he's not from the hood? I mean, if he's from the hood, what? Angie don't strike me as no hood girl. Not no ever. They trying to mark of them as being in high school back in Queens. I gotta look at season one to see how in the hell. How did they come from the same Ghost and Tommy from the same neighborhood, right? But Kanan is not from Tommy's neighborhood. Fuck, I gotta look at season one. That's what the hell I gotta do. Papa in there looking at season one, too. Now, he got the headphones on. Papa, can you hear me? Papa! Is Ghost and Tommy know each other from Queens, right? From high school. And the Angela person, are you looking at season one now? In Queens. But then how does Ghost know Kanan? Kanan from the hood part of Queens. Ain't Tommy from Bayside, Queens, and Angela? Aren't they from a more nicer section of Queens? But how did Ghost cross-pollinate neighborhoods like that? Did he live in Bayside and hung out in Southside? How did the writers do that? Don't they know people from Queens looking at this show and know what the fuck going on with neighborhoods? What episode you up to now? Season one, episode one. Okay, Papa, please, if you get to the neighborhood talk, jot down how does Ghost and Kanan know each other? Did Ghost cross-pollinate? Because you know Angela didn't grow up on no damn South Side. Okay. Yeah, but the hood don't let strangers in like that. You can't, see, writers, dear God, did they even hire writers from the hood? People who are watching this show that ain't hood, just looking at shit for pure entertainment, they don't fucking know. But someone from the hood of a certain age, no, you don't just be a plumb stranger entering a hood. You can't be a plumb stranger entering a hood to visit a girlfriend, much less trying to score a business deal. You know what I mean, guys? Comedians talked about that shit in Def Comedy Jam, of which I went to the audience and saw a few shows live. Some comedian was saying how he was out on a date with a girl and she was living in the projects and he was trying to drop her off three blocks away. She was like, why don't you take me home? He was like, oh, hell no. Not in your neighborhood. Niggas surrounding my car and cutting a plum living fucking fool. Oh, it's dangerous just to visit a bitch. Let alone you trying to get some money. The writers, I don't know who the fuck Courtney hiring, but these writers should know hood politics. Okay, especially if they trying to do a period piece of back in the days when Kanan knew Ghost. How would Ghost know a Tommy and an Angela and a Kanan unless Ghost is really a ghost? Cross-pollinating hoods, but you still got to be ushered in. You don't just walk in the fucking hood. I don't care, give a fuck how much Prince of Darkness energy you carry. That's like if you cooking, right? And you got to temper the eggs. Like you have to add an egg to something hot. This is how the hood niggas taught me back in the day. Okay, now, you don't just throw an egg in some hot shit. It's going to curdle. And niggas like, who is this curdle fucking nigga? You get fucked up and it's fucked up in the game, okay? You got to add a little bit from the pot, the hot water, the hot mixture, whatever the fuck. That's the hood right there, the pot, right? You add a little of that with the egg and you temper, you slowly. Then you introduce the whole body into the fucking pot of food. That's how you introduce a new nigga into the circle. They need to hire me. Stop fucking bullshitting. Because go on and finish watching season one, Daddy. Let me know how does Ghost. You know, I get passionate with the shit. I'm so mad I'm hooked on this show. It just it pisses me off. How did he cross-pollinate hoods? That is not easy to do. You're born with that trait. It's in your natal chart. You can't just do that. It's dangerous. Me as a female, I can't cross. I never got beat up or jumped. But when I used to go to Brooklyn to visit Aunt, that was my dude and shit. I was, just skipping through in the 80s, thought it was cute with my Fendi bag, jewelry, the door knockers. I don't know what the fuck I was thinking in Brooklyn from Queens, tip top. He said, come through, we'll smoke. Purely platonic, Papa. Purely platonic. And chicks encircled me. I was like, oh, damn. Oh, God. And they was like, so what's up with that bag? I was like, well, what's up with it? I got it from the Fendi store. They were like, what you gonna do with it? I was like, I'm wearing it. And I said, I often wonder, shit, you can feel the fucking vampires and sharks and clothes. I said, I often wondered when there's a whole collective stealing one item, how is it shared? Do you wear it on Monday? Do you wear it on Tuesday? And, it was more than 7 fucking days, 7 bitches and 7 days a week. And then, Anthony came running. He got down and he said, oh, back the fuck up. Are you with me? And he just said, he said to stop the shit. They was like, well, who is she? He was like, that's my cousin. Yeah. And then they giving him like, oh, we ain't know. See, he didn't fucking curdle. I curdled. Thank heavens he rescued the curdle effect. Oh, Jesus. You can't just, I'm telling you, you can't enter hoods like that. Not properly. You look at mafia fucking movies. Do you look at mafia motherfucking movies? Remember the old movies when they would introduce a new fucking, it's new. It's fucking new. Who's this new person? What the fuck is this shit? It's like a fly to them in the fucking mixture. And then they will tell him in no uncertain terms, well, you're responsible for him. Remember that shit in movies? You introducing this new energy into our circle. If he's not on the up and up, motherfucker, what he get, you gonna get bitched too. And we don't care, we love you. You're responsible for this new frequency you're introducing to the fold. So again, the writers have to be very clear on how did Ghost come from a Tommy Angela environment to a motherfucking Kanan. That's all I'm asking. So we're going to watch season one. When I finish this video, I'm going to come join you and watch season one, Daddy. To figure out how this shit happened. The continuity. I hope they don't think the viewers are dumb. I don't know. Well, if you're not from the hood, I guess you wouldn't be in the know. I guess you just wouldn't be in the know. I guess. Even with sororities and fraternities, how they, maybe even gangs, I don't know. How they initiate you in and it's just, oh. I'm telling you, my mother ain't telling me the whole story, her initiation. She almost slipped, but she shut up. Sworn an oath of silence and shit. But the little thing she said, I was like, Mom, they did what? Oh, my God. I was fucking mortified, Daddy. Mortified. I don't know much. I ain't supposed to. But the whole thing is you don't just come into a new circle freely like that. You don't get in free. How did Ghost know Kanan?
We worked for Kanan.
How? If he's from Bayside, how? How do you get in a fold like that with a whole new hood?
He knows
Tommy and Angela. They're very Caucasoid. Well, she's Puerto Rican. She seems Caucasoid. I forget that she's Boniqua. She has no hips. Why is she so skinny? They don't want hips shown in the show for some reason. Are they trying to take hips out of the center? Do you see natural hips and booty anymore? Or is it all faux ass? When the last time you saw real ass on TV and hips and shapely? You know what I'm saying? I'm like, do they not want the visuals of, is it power? That's real power, real hips, okay? Not with big and bodacious and too much. I remember Will Smith said some shit better today. He said, I like it neat. I'm paraphrasing. He said, I like it neat. Anything like that is too much. It's too nasty. Will Smith is funny as hell. But at least it was natural back then. I'm from Spanish Harlem, Queens by way of Harlem. And who wasn't dragging hips and ass in the hood? What part of Spain is Angela? I don't know her real name. Did you see her when she stood at the door when she told Proctor to get the fuck out of here? She don't even curse hood. Is she must have been raised very privileged. Because I forget she's Spanish. She would be a Caucasoid. I don't know what y'all know. But just no hips. And nothing against her as a human being, but it's like there's a hidden power that don't want hips shown. Even at Truth. Remember the Asian chick, Papa? When she came to serve the effing vodka with the shots, I said, well, how many Asians you see with hips? But just, It's as if they don't want hips and real ass shown no more. Something going on, Daddy. Now, all these years, I don't know what's the power behind looking at someone beautiful, curvy. Think of Thelma from Good Times. When the last time you seen a body like that on TV? Think of Teresa Graves, Rosalind Cash, Debbie Allen's body back in her heyday, Felicia Rashad's body, Pam Grier, all these beautiful bodies, Teresa Randall. It's like they don't want certain looks to be repped. Natasha got booty, Lala got booty, but I'm not sure if they got hips. I gotta look again, see if Lala got hips. I believe they got their real titties and they got their real booty, but see, hips and thighs and ass is gluteus maximus. That's the Sagittarian rulership, that area. So it could be something anti-Sag, or I don't know. Do you get the Sag effect on you by watching it and admiring it? Not that I have fruity teas running through me. Come on, Papa, you know. But I'm very observant. I'm trying to understand why they not. Not just this show, Papa. Look at all modern shows. Show me some hips and ass, and I'd be like, well, goddamn, maybe they didn't. It's a stoppage of beautiful, natural bodies being shown. Mm. Anyway, Papa, I'm back to my power review. I'm glad you decided to look at season one so we can figure out how they know each other, okay? Daddy, go on now. I'm not an editor shit, but once I get someone to work my channel, I'm going to get the videos edited and get the shit done right. If whoever listened don't like the shit, click off the motherfucker. Okay, now. Okay, smooth top table. What scene I'm up to? Angela trying to... Yeah, outside Angela trying to gas Tasha. Like, Tasha ain't hood and known that bitch was trying to gas. But Tasha, your eyes look like you were slipping. See, the heart, when someone breaks your heart and shit, it's hard, you know, your emotions get into play and things of that nature. But you shouldn't let nobody outside your home nucleus get in your head like that. Especially her, someone who gave your husband head. But Tasha, what the fuck? Writers, have Tasha a little strong mentally, please. Ooh. Anyway. Yeah, don't break bread, drink tea with that bitch. No outside bitch, okay? All right, now, Tyreek and Slim. Okay, next scene. Tyreek and Slim. Oh, yeah, Tyreek must be, yeah, I think he's a virgin. The whole thing with Tyreek, y'all, I know he's getting on everybody's nerves, like he's betraying his parents. But there's a rite of passage during your coming of age years for men and young men and young women. And I think, I know, even in real life, off the script, a young man looks up to an alpha male. That's what they do. I think that's why they're trying to obliterate the planet of the alpha. And that's a whole other topic and video. Anyway, but that's why he looks up to him. Like, as he said, they are real, and it speaks to that energy. You know what I mean? I done told y'all about the Ogun and Legba, that whole pantheon. It speaks to that, and it awakens that. So he's hanging around Slim and his friends and his girls there, and that's another rites of passage, his virginity being, I don't like the term, lost, you know, you lost your virginity, because that means like you, it was sometimes in some instances, unfortunately, is taken from you, like someone took it. But if you gift it away, if you give it away, it's not a loss. You voluntarily gave it away. So I think that's what that scene was about, you know, the transformation of Tyreek from boy to manhood. And he's, you know, doing things that he don't even need to do. Well, then it froze the account, but this is before they learned that Banksy, you know, froze up the shit. And, oh, Tasha, if you ain't have no cash in the stash somewhere at your mama's house, it's important to be kind to certain family members where they can hold some shit down for you, okay? Distant family that may not be on the records. You know, the writers, come on, get with the daggone. Are the writers from the hood? I know you would need lawyers and cops, for the legal jargon, but that's consulting. They ain't got to join the writing team. You can consult with those, okay? But it should be some hood. Well, 50 Cent should know that. It got to be hood people on that writing team. It got to be. Because family members should have cash buried, sealed properly, buried in the backyard. Some goddamn. Tasha, girl, don't tell me all the fiat was up in the bank. What's it, girl? What? Oh, Lord. No. All right, the next scene is Tom. Not that I have the fiat. Y'all don't be when she tell me what? No. I ain't big balling out of control, okay? I'm like, don't be looking at my family house for shit, okay? Regular average Jane over here. All right, now. And writer and Astro Mama, of course. All right, so Tommy, the next scene is Tommy and 718 guy. It was, you know, some other guy walked in. I don't remember the names. Yeah, I remember the shit. The scene, you know, the scene set up. He walked in and he was quite perturbed what happened to the other guy. And Tommy made some handicap statement. They get better parking space. Let me tell you something. Tommy, whoa, Tommy, you are the show. You are comic relief. I was a little put off that, you know, Lala, they got you and Lala getting busy. And I'm like, no, leave Lala. Leave her pure and precious. It's too late. Lala, you're not afraid your son to watch this show? I know now, you know, you monitor his TV viewing. But, like, when he grow up, you're not afraid he'll, like, buy the DVDs? Or will he even have DVDs when he grow up? I don't know what the hell. But whatever be comparable at that time or just heightened in technology. I don't know. I just hope the baby don't see that. Jeez. Yeah. That's neither here nor there right now. Okay, so, yeah, Tommy, you are comic relief. The Tommy character is dope. He just ties it all together. He is psychotic and crazy and funny as hell. And he seems to have a genuine concern for Tyreek and Raina and the other baby. That is very, very, that's key. That's dope. You know, everyone needs someone to give a shit about you, the uncle, you know, just, you know, I don't get the heebie. To me, the worst scum on earth, people, adults, who harm children. So if you don't harm children, to me, you're decent. I'm sorry, you just are. If you don't harm senior citizens and children, you are decent. So Tommy has that redeeming quality that he actually cares about Tyreek and Raina and the kids. I even get that he cares about Tasha, her well-being and things of that nature. Right now, we don't know what the future seasons will bring with Tasha and him, especially when she found out that him and Keisha fucking. All right, so yeah, Tommy gave that little comic relief with the handicap parking joke and shit. And another thing, Tommy, when the hood forgets you're white, nigga, you in. And I say nigga with all due complimentary intones, okay? You could forget Tommy's. Is it me? Or do y'all forget Tommy's white watching this shit? And it's not like he's trying to feign hood gestures or, you know, well, he's an actor and he's you know, simulating the role he's supposed to be doing. But, you know, you can tell when Caucasoid is trying to mock it or trying too hard. Like, you get the instant heebie-jeebies. It feels achi-kachi. Like, no, that's not it. But, like, Tina Marie, you forget she's Caucasoid. I don't really like calling her Caucasoid. Blessings be upon your spirit, queen. You see my point? There's my point. You just completely do not see her in the white light no more. No pun intended. Spiritual pun, if you know what I mean. Yeah, I remember years ago, Wendy Williams was at some award show, and she stopped Justin Timberlake and called him an honorary black person. They laughed. It was cute. You know, it was cute for them. And I was like, is he? Well, I don't listen to his music, so. But I'm almost certain then, as I am now, when I look at him, I'm remembering clearly that he's Caucasian. But some Caucasians, you just look at them and forget, like Eminem. I don't remember he's white. Could be looking right in his face in the interview. I don't know. Again, Tommy, you done got. I done spoke to another hood comrades and comradettes. They're like, you know, I gotta forget Tommy's white. I'm like, me too. Tommy, that's some dope shit. I don't study Neptune. We don't get it. Study Neptune. You don't understand how that's the dopest compliment ever. Okay. All right. Now moving on along. Next scene: Keisha and Tasha. Oh yeah, Keisha, Tasha and Keisha talking about the deal that was offered, the gift rather, the faux gift, the foul fierce, feral gift that was offered to Tasha from Angela. I don't like where this is going because Keisha is telling Tasha, you know, look out for yourself. Don't trust ghosts. And I understand she may be trying to be a good friend, but I don't know how it vacillates the trust cord between ghost and Tommy is scary too. And this is why psychics are important. Real psychics are very, very important. So you don't have to have that inner struggle with whether you should trust someone who's close to you or not. Okay? Just my opinion. Okay. And I've been to good ones. I've been to Costa Rica. I've been out the country to real, there's real, real shaman good ones out there. Okay. Don't get it fucked up. But that's off the script. But on the script. Yeah. So Keisha, telling Tasha, you know, be careful, yada, yada, yada. Being a good friend. But I still don't understand why you can't tell you fucking Tommy, Keisha. What's she going to do? Spank y'all? What the fuck? Why is that secret? You know, and you all told him, you know, I have a son. You could be there for us. Keisha's no need to compete in that area. There's no competition. He's been in Tyreek and Raina's life since babyhood. What? Girl, take that vanilla pole and shut the fuck up. But Keisha, don't start competing with Tasha. Stop it. Unless the writers are trying to write something with that, like maybe you've been low-key envious of Tasha all the years. I don't know. I'm hoping that's not the case. All right, now, the next scene, Andre and 718 at Truth talking about the Fed feedback and things of that nature. And, yeah, he questioned Andre, why you told Tommy I was in there longer with the Feds. The better answer, I guess the writers are not supposed to let it make too much sense. But the better answer I would have said to motherfucking Tommy ass is, well, I have no control on how long the fuck they keep us. I know what you do have control over is studying and shit. And I got 95 credits in legal studies. If you kept longer than five, first of all, you didn't even have no lawyer present. I would have been like, well, where's the lawyer? I have no lawyer present. Okay, I want to talk to the fucking lawyer. And then you kept longer than 5 minutes without being charged. That's called kidnapping. Let's get them change the statute. Get your Google on. And that's what the fuck I would have been telling Tommy. Like, look, I had no control beyond my control. What the fuck? I know I was sitting there dummying up. It was a patience game. They were trying to outweigh the silence. I don't know, nigga. What the fuck? Okay? But I know somebody trying to throw some shit in the game to raise the eyebrow my way. Okay? I would have gave Red Tommy the motherfucking Riot Act and Andre, too. I don't know what the fuck y'all both niggas trying to do. But this is how it's going to go down, okay? All right, so the next scene is Ghost and Tasha visit, and they don't use no alcohol swabs. Again, I know it's a set. I know there's probably people on the set cleaning and shit. But for the psychology of the critical thinker looking at the shit, can y'all have Tasha whip an alcohol swab out her purse and clean the damn phone, please? You can buy them shits at the drugstore. When I used to visit niggas back in the day, even when I went with my friend, she would visit her husband. And I sat next to her, she was like, you got alcohol swabs? So I said, here, girl, the job I had, I always walked with them and gloves. Okay? Clean them phones before y'all use it. What the part of the game is that shit? Get the creepies and heebie-jeebies. Ooh. Okay, now, next scene, 718 Andre, FM Barker's two shot glasses. I done spoke to that when Papa came here to visit me, my beloved. They were talking and things of that nature. And I'm wondering why that Asian chick don't have no hips. I don't know. I know y'all probably, what Asian got hips? Why won't they show curves anymore? I don't know, you're like, you're a female, would you care? No, I'm thinking that there's some sort of a spiritual reason that they're totally withdrawing that from public view. If you a sister with a shapely body and you go out into the world, and not only that, remember Muhammad Ali was in an interview and he was saying that they were talking about why your women got to be covered up. And he said, because earth hides her treasures, all the treasures and diamonds, all that stuff is well hidden. So if they're hiding the beauty of a natural curvy body, when those sisters go out to the grocery store, y'all must get really, really hounded, like looked at as beautiful aliens or something. Because they damn sure ain't putting it on TV. No, but they unmainstreaming curves. What part of the game? But it just makes it more of a cachet. When you do the things that they're hiding, when you see it, you really celebrate it because it's like a hidden treasure, in my opinion. It's a cachet. And you're giving it more scorpion energy because you're hiding it. Never mind. Back to the scenes of power. Season 4, episode 4, 404. What is that on the internet world? Unfounded? Okay. Catch. Okay, next scene is Raina is snooping around Tyreek's room doing sibling shit. I guess Tyreek's sharp and stark contrast in character is making Raina curious. And Tasha's too busy dealing with this ghost mess and whatever the fuck she's worried about, surviving things. She may not even have noticed the stark contrast in Tyreek's character, which would be there probably if things were normal, what's normal for ghosts in them, because he's going through this teenage phase, machismo, and rites of passage, so there would be a shift anyway. during this time, but it's intensified with a person named Slim, a.k.a. Kanan, in his life. Now, Raina finds the money in Tyreek's room. And, of course, Tyreek breaks in. Well, not breaks in, but he comes through with the F you doing in my room, just talking to a real grease ball. You know what I'm saying? Like, you know, the hood is just staining all sense of fucking common decency in his ass. You know, Slim all stained up in his goddamn teeth, mouth, and aura. You know, just talking to his sister real greasy. What the fuck wrong with you? Okay, so she leaves, and that's that. And the next scene is court with Proctor and them. They in court. Proctor and them, you know, and the shit goes down. The shit goes down. No, I think they leave the court. Is that another scene? When they upend the case and Proctor's asked to leave the case. And that's really fucked up. Yeah, that's just fucked up how they took Proctor off the case. You know, but that's what the oppressive system does. Anyone who's really in, they try to make supporting these people that they don't like illegal, call it accomplice or aiding and abetting and all this other bullshit. And sometimes you're like, well, how do you know if you're aiding and abetting if your fucking loved one ain't telling you what they did? They could just be there like, I'm hungry, I need a bath, I need a bed. How the fuck do you know? What the fuck? Huh? You know, oh, we saw the All Ports Bulletin on the news. Well, what if you don't even look at the news? I'm about to hear the muse. What if you don't look at the news? Because it's negative and you stop watching this shit, it's depressing as hell. What if you just don't even watch that shit? What the fuck? Oh, my heaven. So anyway, the aim is to isolate you. So, especially from those who are really sincerely trying to help you. So they got rid of Proctor's ass and left Ebony. They broke up the Ebony IRE, broke up the black and white magic, if you can call it that, with Ebony's coon. Oh, he vibe like a coon. Ugh. No finesse, no charisma, just like he looked like he danced worse than Urkel. Just, and he looked shiny and greasy. His makeup putting shine, some sort of gloss shine on his forehead. I don't like him. And he don't even like Ghosts. And that's what Ghosts is left with. Ain't that some bullshit? Oh, jeez. Can't Ghosts get somebody to fuck new? Oh, I don't know. Anyway, so Tommy, okay, next thing. Tommy delivers the $20K to the the wife Connie is there with some other guy there. And they was talking, you know, Tad Sharp, and Connie came out into the living room. She, you know, she appreciate the scene and what was going down, okay? And that was fucked up, you know, extortion, you know, all that shit. Because the next scene is Tommy and Keisha fucking. That's when she was out back telling him, reminding him she has a son and you could be there with. And that scene looked realer than real deal Holyfield. It really did. Pretty tattoos, Lala. Pretty tattoos. You showed your tattoo, talking about the T sound, phonetic. You showed your tatas. I'm like, Lala, oh my. And she's a Cancer, and Cancer rules the breast. I'm like, well, are they doing some other kind of ritual? Why she showed her what the fuck going on? It ain't for the coinage. So she must be really trying to express her acting and, you know, come out of the shell. Some astro pun intended. We like our Lala pure. I don't know. The scene look hot and real as a motherfucker, okay? But I just, they couldn't hire someone else. Oh, why y'all taint our Lala? Oh, power producers. Oh. Anyway, so the scene was hot and fiery. They got through the scene. And I got through it. I had to walk away. I'm like, just leave our Lala alone. Good heavens. We like our luminaries how we like them. Just tainting them. Just, right, I'm over myself. Let me drink some more water. Alrighty. Okay, so the next scene is the house, the brownstone robbery with Slim and them. And the kid was home drinking lean upstairs, carrying on. And my thing is, with this type of level of fiat that these Caucasoids have in their coffers, how's there no interior cameras, and Slim and the guy don't have on gloves or a mask again? Okay, you can't wear masks going in, neighbors and two Caucasoids with the babies and all that other bullshit, and the cutie pie, and the cop uniform jukebox must have got for his ass and shit. I don't know. And you know what? When I used to date some law enforcement, when I worked in law enforcement back in the days, you know, you date each other. And you often wondered, like in the hood, you see the Caucasoid cops, right? And then you're like, well, there's brother cops. What do they send the brothers? So when I saw him in that Upper East Side, Upper West Side neighborhood, I'm like, look at the irony there. They probably send the brothers with his no crime. And even when there's no crime in the hood, the Caucasians still come through harassing and stopping and frisking. Remember they did sweeps in the 80s, 50s? And my fat ass, well, I was plump then. I wasn't that chubby. But getting my, you know, my hero sandwich, my bonton, wise potato chip, Tahitian treat, Frusion glage ice cream, getting all my goodies out the store. And I'm like, they were like, nah, don't, you know, they just, I'm like, where am I getting my goodies from? You know, just a snack tube addict, terrible. TV and snacks, you know, just shit. Anyway, I'm like, ain't this some bullshit? So I was petrified to go to the corner store, the bodega, for a long time. I'm like, I'm innocent as all. I may date them, you know, but I'm innocent. You know I'm innocent from the type of work I used to do. You got to clear security and shit. You can fingerprints like a motherfucker. But I used to date them, you know. The hood back in the days, the good old days, you know. But in any event, I used to have to say, well, damn, I have to go in the city and get my goodies from the newsstand. You ain't running the sweep on a newsstand in Manhattan. But, you know, the candy is more expensive. They don't have specific candy there. I was so mad about them sweeps and shit. Ugh. But they'd be all Caucasoid. Because when you see it, you're like, they don't hire your brothers? Every now and again, you may see a little brother's. I digress. Never the fuck mind. But yeah, those scenes with the robbery 50, I don't understand how it's no gloves. And why what the fuck would you want a flat screen? The guy that was with you made more sense saying, well, I'm looking for narcotics. You know, they'd be doing opiates or whatever the fuck he said they was doing. I guess pills or whatever the fuck he was looking for, quaaludes. I don't know. 50 Cent, why? Who wrote in a flat screen? How is that worth any fucking thing in this day and age when you can get them at Walmart for a little over $100? Maybe less if they on the rollback sale doing the shit. What? Why write us a flat screen? As conspicuous as that would be walking out the goddamn door, would it look like they donated it to Goodwill? What could you even get for that at the fucking pawn shop? This is Keisha. You know the video channel I'm talking about. Y'all look at Keisha. You are right, girl. The writing is getting lazy. A flat screen. Aren't you supposed to be looking for jewelry or some shit, artifacts, art? A fucking flat screen? I was too thrilled with that scene. And this is running over 30 damn minutes, okay? Well, click off if you're tired of listening to the shit. I do this same reason I write, to outlet, purge. I do this for an outlet, not for impatient ears like yours. Click off. Okay, the patient ones who's enjoying my feedback to this shit, welcome. Okay, next scene. Proctor and Ghost visit. Proctor gives him the bad news. I'm a little your attorney. I felt that, though. Proctor, you're good. And I told you, endeared to me from, what's the shit? Think Like a Man, that bullshit title for the women in the video, a movie. When you did the little spin, when you thought y'all was robbed and she redecorated. Yeah, never mind. I reiterate. That's what I do. Okay. You don't like it? Click off. All right. So he's telling him, but the acting was superb. You really, really look like you were dismayed at the whole shit. You got to leave the case. It's fucked up. Okay. The next scene, Tasha's at the school talking to the principal. She let her know that the check was returned and all that. They froze the accounts. Y'all should plan for shit like that. Look at here. Did you not see the Queens of Comedy when Samorden told you? You know they're going to come with some shit down the line. They do that in the so-called legal beagle sector. Honest shit. It's just, see, that they're ruled by Aries, and Aries rules sports, and that's games, and Aries rules males because of Mars, and Aries rules law enforcement. It rules the color red and number one in the head and the body. Aries rules the ego. Tasha and Ghost, y'all have to have planned for shit like that. That's why I said y'all didn't have no family, your mama, auntie, cousin that you trust, that, you know, that would hold something. Well, I guess you would have to really trust them. You gotta really plan. We're saying homeschool. They should have been homeschool anyway when shit hit the fucking fan. Then you gotta pay the homeschool teachers. You see, do it your motherfucking self. I don't know. But they shouldn't even be there know-how when shit going down like this. Okay? And always think like an Aries to understand them. They love Capricorn too. They love Saturn. Don't get fucked up. You know why. I'll write it in my ebook later. To get in their head, you have to think like an Aries. You really do. Yeah, y'all need me on the writing squad. Unless y'all been instructed for it not to make sense. That's a whole nother video. Maybe y'all told this can't make too much sense now. The age of Aquarius, we can't spark intelligence. Yeah. Mm-hmm. So I don't know. Anyway, so Keisha, the next scene, Keisha's shop gets shut down. And it was so cute. She was so sassy with them, things of that nature. And I was like, hell, if this was off script, they would have been pepper sprayed by now. But it was a melanated law enforcement, you know, repping law enforcement. So I said, maybe not. She's pretty. Maybe she wouldn't have got pepper sprayed. But in so-called real life, she was sassing up like that. I'm like, oh, Lordy, girl. But that was a cute scene when she sassed back and they shut shit down. Again, not preparing. Y'all need fucking psychics or something. Just not preparing. What the fuck? You got to prepare. Did I tell you to think like an Aries? Y'all bullshitting if you want to. Okay, then they show it's truth getting shut down. Dre calling. Keisha called Tasha, let her know. And then Dre called Tommy, let him know. And, you know, just... Did Johnny not hear public, even though it's not in proper context? But when the Dre scene, when he said truth got shut down, did y'all not long for him to play Public Enemies, the remix that Pete Rock did for Shut Him Down? Shut Him Down. Shut. That was the shit. Especially the remix. That was the shit. Did you not hear that music right there at that scene? But even though that, you know, Public Enemy did theirs for the liberation of our people, so it'd have been totally out of context. But heavens, if I ain't hear that, just, oh, they should have, 50, y'all should have got the publishing, you sample, you get a publishing, you get license to do the shit, just a little snippet of that, right? That would have been dope. Okay, at home, no, but then that's giving young people old school real hip-hop music. I know y'all not instructed to do that. Because a young person hear P.E. shut it down, they may go look for the song and then open up the catalog. No, they don't want young generation hearing the public. They may have heard it from their parents if they, you know, but that I don't think that would be the plan. So I don't know. They ain't gonna let him play. They ain't let Flavor Flav play no PE on his damn show yet. Not to compare that fool show, no offense, Flav, to Power, but you see what I'm saying. Okay, moving on to the next scene. At home, Tasha and the kids, Tyreek. Oh, yeah. That's when she got the call from Keish. That scene, and Tyreek decides not to go home. He doesn't get off the elevator at all. He presses the down button and gives Raina the finger on the way down. He was truly descending literally and descending psychologically. Like, he just lost his mind on his way to get his next taste, his first taste. That's it, his first taste of some pow you, okay? And go and give Raina the bird. Tyreek, what the fuck is wrong with you? Oh, machismo is a bitch. It's a bitch. It's a bitch and a half, I tell you. All right, so the next scene, Dre and Slim. Okay, Dre comes to the house, gives Slim the 50K payment. They're in the kitchen talking. He notices Tyreek is there. And he's like, why is Tyreek here? Why? What the fuck? Why? What's going on? And Slim is like, he's having a good time, you know. They're going to bring up his daughter again to him. Just, oof. Kanan, if you want us, writers, if you want us to hate Kanan, it's working. But when 50 Cent smiled, that little thing his eye does, the side of his eye does, when his eyes smile, his smile can make you forgive all the bullshit, isn't it? Oh, I'm like, if 50 don't smile, we can continue to hate Kanan ass in peace. He bring up the little daughter for her. Oh, leave kids and senior citizens the fuck alone. That's how y'all ascend to what's called heaven. Okay? Yeah, your grave misdeeds, as grave as gravity, grave misdeeds keep you lodged on this. Never mind, that's a whole nother damn video. But leave the babies and the elders alone. Just, it's cowardice. It's cowardice, excuse me. Not less, hell no. Cowardice. Be messing with babies and elders. Oh, God, y'all better get that book, Cobbleline, by the three initiates. Oh, I got a whole other. I need to do a video for books. Book list recommend. Okay. Oh, yeah, party time. Oh, another thing about this senior citizen. The bedroom that he about to fuck in is all senior citizen and decor. Who is paying the rent writers? Who is paying that elderly lady's rent? Where's her family? No one visits her. No great grandkids. No hell, a great grandniece. But especially in New York, there's a relative somewhere, maybe 2-3 blocks away. If they don't visit often, they may visit to beg for some money. Writers, who is paying this woman's rent? Why do they think the viewers are dumb? Yes, it's these little critical nuances that makes the story bullshit. What makes the story real and truthful is the little tiny details that tie together to make sense. Continuity. Yes, we know it's a script. But still, when you want to get, like, we forget Tommy's white. You want to forget you're looking at a fucking TV show. You want to forget you're looking at a movie. You want to become immersed in the story where you forget you're even at home. You want to teleport there with them. Come on, writers, enthrall us. If I got to keep thinking, who's paying this old lady rent? What are her neighbors saying? Did she go to church? Does the church members not know? What the fuck? What, does she not have one relative in New York City, which is highly unusual for elderly people in the city? What? Writers. Well, writers. Maybe I got your instructions too from hitting a hand at being, and you gotta write dumb. I don't know. Or y'all don't have no Mercury retrogrades in the clique. Mercury retrogrades are your writers of society. Could the whole team be Mercury retrograde free? Because a Mercury retrograde person would remember that. Like, no, wait. Who's paying this woman's rent? Mercury directs is going forward. They, you see, Mercury directs. If y'all all Mercury directs on the writing team, your audience ain't all Mercury directs. Shit. Oh, okay. Now back to the next scene. Tyreek writes a passage. Oh, yeah, that's a bedroom. Yeah, I didn't spoke about that. Scorpio, your transformation. Fucking. Mm-hmm. What else I wrote here? Okay, next scene. Tommy's at Proctor's house hiding out for the stiff guy. Forgive me, I forgot his name. This to him. Fed agent, he comes through with the laptop and all this and all that. They talking, you know, proof on deck, receipts on deck, digital receipts on deck for your motherfucking ass. Then Tommy just off and kills the motherfucker. I mean, some gladiator shit, okay? Motherfucking barbarian shit to the nth power. I don't know. I guess Tommy didn't want Proctor's neighbors hearing shit. That was a nice apartment. His baby mother got a nice apartment too. You know, lawyers get, I guess, Corker's lawyers getting paid like that. I guess the fuck so. I only got 95 credits. I'm still trying to get my 120 just to get the degree to my mama. Because she's like, you really going to forget about it? Just 25 credits shy? I said, mom, the school won 11,000. It was 9,000. They're going to go up and shit. I asked them, how the fuck y'all going to go up? Yes, I said fuck on the phone. I'm so sick of that damn school. They was like, well, miss, you know, calm down. They did some bogus shit. I said, I learned contract law at your goddamn school. I didn't sign no shit saying that you can go up 2 G's. Is that shit in paper? Is that on writing? Did I sign some shit? 2 signatures in an agreement. I didn't sign no shit saying you can go up 2 G's. If there's a lawyer listening to this, can you help me get my degree, please, from my school? Please. Okay, it's some fuck shit. I'll tell you the whole shit. Email me, wisdomwanda@gmail. Wisdomwanda, Wanda spelled with an H at the end. Wisdomwanda@gmail. All rights reserved on this video, all my videos, UCC1-308, all rights reserved. Email me if you a lawyer and you ain't do your pro bono for the year and you want to help a gal get her degree, legal studies, okay? I don't know. This loop is going to allow me to work with this year. Maybe I work from home. I don't know. But I want to give it to my mama. She has her degree. My mother has her 2 degrees. So, you know, I'll be her first offspring to give her one. That's why she wanted. Because I'm so close to 95 credits. Okay. Oh, I ain't going to talk about that school no more. Just some icky shit. Then they was going to try to give me the scholarship, the short daddy leg scholarship for seniors. And then they did some fugazi fuck shit. Well, you see, I don't want to get into conspiracy theories, but never the fuck mind. But it's some fuck shit going on. And I would call a school out, you sons. I want my dad gone degree. And how you going to, I want to pay the 9,000 too. How you going to go, what is it, 9-11? You going to go up to 11? What kind of fucking ritual is that? See, Now, I don't remember if I wrote my papers to the degree where they would know I study outside the box. But I said, was on the phone like, this is some bullshit. And with the guy on the phone, the secretary, you know, just, I ain't talk about that school no more. Just, Point of the matter is, I know. What the secret said, you know, you gotta know like you know like you know. I know that in academia, from what the hell they taught and other shit, teachings. And I know that my intuitive ability, never mind. Back to power. So he kills this guy, and Proctor's freaking the fuck out. Because, you know, you can tell he's a little high-strung, but straight-laced, and he probably ain't never witnessed a little crate, even though he said he knows somebody can help him dispose of it. I was like, Proctor, you do? Ooh, mercy. But you can tell he ain't probably even witnessed no crazy shit like that at all. Again, Tommy is the motherfucking show, which bothers me, because I want Ghost to be the show, because, you know, I do. Melanin, I don't know, I do, but Tommy's taking this shit by leaps and bounds, fuck what you heard. Then he, you know, takes the knife and wipes it on Proctor's hoodie. I'm like, ooh, Proctor, how you gonna clean that out? What you gonna do with that? You gonna burn it? Gonna put it in a bowl of ice water and burn it and then dry it? Ooh, boy, I don't know. After you clean it all up, I suggest you get some cedar sage. You gotta probably get strong as you get a high priestess or something to come clean that damn apartment out. Smoke it out, okay? You want the spirit of that agent to smoke the shit out, smoke it out, okay? Now, I will smoke it out anyway, even though it's acting. subconscious mind, there's no respect of what the fuck is what. Whole nother video, whole nother topic. Okay, now. Tend a new lawyer. What's that real name? Find a new lawyer in New York City. Oh yeah, Tommy said some shit. Find New York. Tommy funny as hell. New York lawyer in New York City. He's a sociopath though. No conscious, just cold and funny as hell. Cold people usually not funny. They're usually stiff and pasty and scary vampire. And no, he got a sense of humor with this shit. Rare combo. So he made that comment out the door. Funny as hell. Okay, old white guy and ghost. Okay, older white guy and ghost is talking. He him ghost up and you know. Ghost mentioned his wife's name. He said, no more blackmail, nigga. I know you, Wigger, rather. I know you, you know me. We know each other. Nice to meet you. Okay. No more blackmail. Stop it. This vampiric bullshit. Vampires. This is why Lauryn Hill wrote that song. Off topic. Okay, back on script. Power. Season 4, episode 4. Okay, Ebony and Ivory. It's the next scene. They in court, a practice fired, or I done jumped the scene with other shit. Y'all figure, piecemeal it together. Parker got fired, he knew it was some fuck shit, he was, you know, speaking his mind, and Judge Seamus, Judge going play golf, ain't that some shit? It's just no conscience, no compassion, no human. You can't be wholly human with no compassion and no conscience, just, so that vampire shit is real. I don't know, I digress. It's scary. I'm up to 51 minutes, y'all. Well, if you ain't got patience, you just click off. You should be listening this long anyhow. Listen to me driving driving to run your errands. Put me in the car and listen to me on the errands, cooking food, whatever the fuck. Okay, now, just, you know, suggestions. You're grown. Do as thou wilt. So whatever. Okay, now, next scene. The CO let Ghost in to see Proctor, the new visit. He told him, okay, I done got shit all fucked up in the game. Piecemeal together, paste and copy, edit and paste, whatever. Okay, the next scene is Proctor goes to Angela's house. Yes, that was, but she was like, how the fuck do you know where I live? Did y'all not worry? I'm like, if they start fucking, I'm gonna be too through with Angela. Did you not get like a sort of sense like the writers could take you on a whole roller coaster of some new shit, some newfangled shit? I'm like, because I think she likes dick, okay? No disrespect, Angela. But I'm like, if they make these two fuck, I'm going to be too thrilled with her. But because he was passionate. And telling her the truth. You know, come on now. He didn't do this shit. So I'm glad he went there. Let some steam off. Let her know she's a bitch. And a fucking vindictive bitch at that. Mad because she has abandonment issues. All right? The Book of Tao said, T-A-O. No one could ever really hurt you. They can only stimulate the hurt that's already within you. But to that I say, it must be some childhood trauma. Because somebody sent the first hurt. Who leveled that first hurt that's within you that unsuspecting others are stimulating unknowingly or some knowingly who know your bio and your past. All right? So that's the abandonment issues in the Angela character. But she want to get ghost ass back, okay? So then she must have, something resonated. Because the passionate Proctor exuded. So she texts Daryl for the footage of Ghost's office. And she sit there and she watched the shit. And she says something to the effect of, I'll be damned. Yes, bitch, he ain't plant no motherfucking. He's not that dumb. How you know? You should have known he wasn't dumb. You was fucking him. Would you be fucking dumb, dick? Like you done told Tasha he's not attracted to dumb? That's not him. But then gonna say gullible the next breath, you know, oxymoron shit. What the fuck is the difference? Well, you could get dickmatized. The oxytocins and dickmatizing. You know, so you could have academic holdings, you know. There's academia holdings and there's another type of intelligence that's far more superior in my opinion, spiritual opinion. I digress. But yeah, but next week looks good. Hopefully Andrew realized that, you know, this shit is a setup. Find the mole. Continue to find the mole in your office, and that's the motherfucker that did it, like Proctor told you. All right? All right, y'all. Peace.